फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर। सो हियर फर्स्ट आई विल कंसीडर कंस्ट्रक्शन, देन वी गो टू द प्रिंसिपल, एंड देयर आर सम ऑफ द कीवर्ड्स दैट वी यूज हियर। द स्टेटर आउटपुट कॉल्ड द थ्री फेज एसी सप्लाई, स्टेटर, रोटर फील्ड वाइंडिंग, डीसी सप्लाई, डैम्पर वाइंडिंग, इक्वल इन सर्क्यूट, वेक्टर डायग्राम। And let us see what are the different types of rotors. So in the synchronous machines or synchronous generators, there are two types of rotors. One is called the cylindrical rotor, that is also called wound rotor. The other one is called the salient pole rotor. This cylindrical rotor is also called non-salient pole rotor. This is the non-salient pole rotor, whereas this is the salient pole rotor. And in case of salient pole rotor, the poles will protrude from the rotor surface like this. This is one pole, this is one pole, this is another pole, this is another pole. Whereas in the wound rotor or cylindrical type rotor or non-salient pole type rotor, the poles are embedded within the surface of the rotor like this. And these are the, this is the stator part. So the stator will have the several slots, and in these slots, so we provide the three phase winding, and similarly here also we find this is the stator, and this will also have the slots in which we keep the three phase winding. Then if you look at them physically, they look like this. This is the cylindrical rotor type. This is also called a non-salient pole rotor. See, there is no pole which is protruding from the surface of the rotor. Everything is within the surface of the rotor. So look at this. This is the salient pole rotor. So if you look at this, this is the rotor surface. Whereas these poles are protruding. So that is why these are the poles from the rotor surface. So they are called the salient pole rotor. Then coming to the principle of the synchronous generator, in general the definition of generator is, it is a machine that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. So here we find the some of the keywords: rotating rotor magnetic field, and it will have the constant magnitude, and it will also run at synchronous speed. And its synchronous speed can be obtained using the formula called 120 f by p, and where f is the frequency and p is the number of poles on the rotor, and the supply that is produced, or the voltage produced from the stator, is 50 hertz supply, and that too it is a three phase AC supply. And then if you look at the one phase of the stator output voltage, it looks like this, and it will have the frequency normally 50 hertz. So in other words, its time period is 20 milliseconds, means its polarity changes for every 10 milliseconds like this. And also we find . So if you look at the rotor circuit, a drawing, you find like this. This is the salient pole rotor diagram like this. This is the rotor, and its poles are protruding like this. So in practice, we find the 18 poles, 20 poles like that. And this is the stator winding and three-phase AC, three-phase winding. That's why the outer part is called the stator, the inner part is called the rotor. So when we look at the outside view of the generator or synchronous generator, it looks like this. So what is the generator principle? It converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. That means The generator will have the two parts, stator and the rotor, and the rotor should be coupled to the a prime mover, means a shaft of the another motor. This is the motor, so which is running at synchronous speed, and that rotor shaft is coupled to the rotor of the synchronous generator like this. This is called the coupler, and this is the motor shaft, and this is the generator rotor shaft. So they are coupled together, and these are the wires coming out of the generator, means from here we find the AC supply coming out. The input to this generator is mechanical input. That mechanical input comes from the motor. This is the motor. So what is the motor? It takes the electrical energy and gives the mechanical output. So it will have the electrical input from here, and that will be converted into mechanical output or mechanical power. That mechanical power is fed to the rotor of the synchronous generator through coupler like this. So once the rotor starts rotating, because it is a salient pole rotor which consists of the DC supply connected to the rotor, so automatically it produces a flux which is rotating within the generator, and that magnetic field will cut the stator conductors. These are the stator conductors. This is the rotor. Say, look at this. This is the salient pole rotor. Here I took a two pole salient pole rotor like this for convenience, and because it is given DC supply, we find the fixed salient pole, I mean south pole and north pole like this, and the input for this rotor is mechanical input, so that comes from the motor shaft, so like this coupled. So means this starts rotating. Once this motor is started, means this rotor starts rotating, and the rotor will always already have the magnetic poles over it. So it is as good as a magnetic field rotating in the within the stator like this. And this magnetic field will cut the stator conductors which are placed in the slots or teeth of the stator, and these windings are three-phase windings. So whenever there is a rate of change of flux linking with the coil or stator winding, there will be induced voltage in the stator winding, and because it is a three-phase winding, we find the three-phase AC supply, a three-phase AC voltage produced in the stator windings, and that stator produced voltage is taken out like this through the terminals like this. These are R, Y, B, and this can be fed to the any three-phase motor or for any other purpose. This is called the rotor field winding, and this the outer part of the stator is called the yoke, and these slots are called the belongs to the stator slots, and winding is called stator winding, and that stator winding is also called armature winding. So that means we have given a mechanical input to this rotor, and as a result that is rotating, and that produces electrical power from the stator windings like this. Here is mechanical input and here is the electrical output. So this is nothing but generator principle, converting mechanical power into electrical power or mechanical energy into electrical energy. So if you draw the equivalent circuit of the synchronous generator per phase, we get like this. This is the rotor winding which is connected to the a DC supply like this, and the supply current flows like this through the rotor winding, that is called rotor field winding, and it will have the inductance called LF and the resistance is called RF. In the laboratory, there is a provision externally to change the resistance of the field winding of the rotor. And this is the stator equivalent circuit. This is the induced EMF per phase in the stator. We call that as EA. And this is the synchronous reactance of the synchronous generator, whereas this is the resistance of the stator per phase. XA is also per phase value. And after, if the load is connected across the terminals of the stator, then a current will flow through that. So the current that flows from the single phase of the stator equivalent circuit is called the armature current or stator current, represented by IA. It goes like this and then reaches the load. So then coming to its vector diagram, it looks like this. So look at this. So what is the maximum voltage that we get here? It is the generated voltage per phase. So take the terminal voltage as the reference here. This is the terminal voltage. So this is the terminal voltage. And let us assume the load connected to the generator is lagging load, so which draws a current called IA and lags by an angle called phi like this with respect to terminal voltage VT. Then to get IEA, so we have to add vectorially the voltage drops across RA and XS. So multiply this RA with IA, that is we get like this IA RA, which is in phase with the current flowing, so that is why it is in parallel with this. Then you have the IA XS, but this leads the current by 90 degrees like this. So this is IA, and perpendicular to this is the IA XS. Then when we add this VT, IA RA and IA XS, then we get the resultant voltage, that is called the induced voltage per phase in the stator winding, is given by EA like this. And the angle between the terminal voltage and the induced voltage in the generator is called delta, whereas the angle between the terminal voltage and the stator current or armature current is called the phi. So let me summarize once. We have seen what is a synchronous generator, or in general what is generator, means that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy is called the generator. In the synchronous generator also the input is mechanical, but the output is AC electrical output. Then here the terms that we covered are three phase AC supplies, what is the stator, what is the rotor, and what are the different types of rotors. We have seen where the stator windings are placed, and we have seen where what is yoke and what is the input to the rotor also covered. And we have seen what is the rotor field winding, what is the DC supply given to the rotor winding, and we have seen what is the equivalent circuit, and we have seen what is the vector diagram of the synchronous generator, and we have seen how the generator looks like externally. That is, it will have a motor coupled to the rotor of the generator like this, and then this from the generator stator winding we get the terminals like this, from these terminals we get the AC power